I played 10 years for Lancashire. I toured 4 times with Pakistan here in about 20 years career. I played for Pakistan. It has been raining all winters, has been the coldest winter, it has been snowing. So it doesn't matter if it's a sunny day at Edgbaston, at Oval, there are 3 venues, and third one is Cardiff. The moisture will be under the pitches, so the ball will seam around. Maybe Cardiff will be slightly flatter, but Edgbaston and Oval got a bit of bounce, there will be a bit of seam, and I think it will suit fast bowlers and team. I reckon who will win here, got to get some runs there for starters. Of course, they're going to play 6 batsmen. Kamran Akmal come at number 7. Then Wahab Riaz, who won them a game about last week against Ireland, got 47. He's emerging to be a very good all-rounder. And then, of course, Junaid is there, the left-arm bowler. You remember him, he got well, did well against India. Then Mohammad Irfan, the 7-foot-tall. I did work with these boys just before coming to IPL for the 18 bowlers we have. Pakistan, PCB has given me these 18 bowlers in Karachi. So we had a camp, and the third bowler would be Wahab Riaz. And then, of course, one and only Saeed Ajmal. And then they have Mohammad Hafeez, who's a complete bowler, maybe number 2, number 3 ranked in the world in ODI. Then they have Shoaib Malik. So they have plenty of variety in their bowling. And if Pakistan batting clicks in this particular Champions Trophy, they do have a chance. Coming to the leadership of Pakistan team, Misbah-ul Haq is the captain. He's very experienced. And in last 6-8 months, he has changed his game. If you remember, before he used to come to bat and he used to block. And if we were chasing or Pakistan were chasing 3-4 and over, he used to go to 6 and over. But now against South Africa, about 2-3 months ago, he changed his game. And I think as far as his leadership concerned, he's very, very experienced. He's more positive, and that's a very good sign for Pakistan. Obviously, I know, you know, being a cricket lover, that their strength is their bowling. Of course, they have variety in their bowling. They have Irfan, they have Junaid, they have Wahab, they have Saeed Ajmal, they have 2 bowlers who can bowl 10 overs. So they've got about 6 to 7 bowlers in their side. But Pakistan team and me and supporters of Pakistan are hoping that I hope their batting clicks under these sort of circumstances or these sort of conditions. Obviously, the fielding hasn't been the best from last 65 odd years as far as the fielding concerned. I think that's where they're slightly weak, but they're improving a lot, they're working hard. But for me, main weakness is their batting, and main weakness is seeing off the first two new balls in first 15 to 20 overs. So the plan should be, let's play the first 15 overs under these conditions in England as test cricket. Let's try not to lose wicket. If you lose one wicket, get to 15 overs, it means Pakistan team did well. And if they get to 250, 240, their bowling can definitely defend that one. Unfortunately, I don't have my parrot or my crystal ball that I can tell you. But one thing for sure, Pakistan team is a very unpredictable side. I rate them very dangerous, and Pakistan team reminds me of Brazilian soccer. It's all raw, it's all talent, and if they stick together and play their cricket according to the plan, then they definitely have a chance. Although they have a very, very strong group, they have to win 2 games out of 3. First is against West Indies, second is against South Africa, and third one is against mother of all game, Pakistan India. So let's see what happens.